Hello everyone, in this session we are going to discuss about the most interesting data structure which has a wide variety of applications in computer science, and that is our tree. As far as our previous lectures are concerned, we have seen the linear data structure, we have seen the concept of array, we have seen the linked list. Stack is also a linear data structure. To define the new data structure, which is tree. Tree is called as a hierarchical data structure. Now, why hierarchical data structure? If you look at this diagram, there is some kind of hierarchy is happening, right? These circles here are called as nodes in data structure. First, understand the terminology behind everything which I am writing. So this is called as the root. Let me give the nodes numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 2 and 3 are called as the child of this parent 1. 1 is the parent of child 2 and 3. 4 and 5 are the children of parent 2. 7 is the children of 4. Okay. 4 and 5 are called as sibling of parent 2. 2 childs with same parent are called as siblings. Okay. These lines here are called as links. Basically, we can term it as an edge also. So what terminologies we have seen so far? First, root. Okay. We have seen the nodes. These circles are nodes. We have seen the children. We have seen the parent. We have seen the sibling. Now, there is one more term which is called as leaf node. Okay. Now, every parent which has no child are called as leaf nodes. Now 9 has no child, right? So this is called as leaf node. 8 has no child. So this is also called as leaf node. 7 is also called leaf node. 5 is also called leaf node. Okay. So with parent with no child are called as leaf nodes. Now the next terminology here is ancestor and descendant. Now if we go from A to B, then A is called as ancestor of B and B is called descendant of A. So these are the terminologies you have to remember. For example, consider this node 9. Okay? Consider this node 9. Now 1, 3 and 6 are called as ancestor of 9 because we travel through this path 1, 3, 6 till 9. Okay, so these are called ancestor and 9 is the descendant of these two nodes. We can go in one direction, okay, like this. From 1 to 2 we can go, from 2 to 1 we cannot. This is unidirectional, not bidirectional, okay. So we have various types of trees also. For this lecture, our main prior focus is on introduction part so that you get the terminologies very clear. Properties of trees. So every tree with n nodes, okay, with n nodes has n minus 1 edges. So what does that mean? For example, here we have 9 nodes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 nodes. And how many edges are there? There should be 8 edges. So, as per our property, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 edges. How to calculate the depth and height of the tree? So depth is called as length of path from root to x, or we can say number of edges from root to x. So if I say what is the depth for this node, say, so length of path from root to x. Okay, so suppose x is 6 here, so 1 and 2. Number of edges from root to that node is called as depth. So the depth of this node is 2, 1 and 2. What is the depth of this node 7? The length of path from root to that node. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 3 edges are there. 3 is the depth of this node 7. What is the depth of 8? 1, 2 and 3. Okay, what is the depth of this second node? 1, only 1 edge. What is the depth of this root node? There is no edge. So we can say the depth of root node is 0. Okay. What is the depth of this 4? Number of edges from root to that number. What is the depth of this? 1, 2. So 2 is the depth of this node 4. What is the depth of 5? 1 and 2. So this is how you can calculate the depth of any node. Now what is the height of the node? Height can be defined as number of edges in longest path from x to a leaf. The height of this node 3 is number of edges in longest path till leaf node. Okay, so 1, 2. 2 is the height of this node 3. What is the height of this 5 node? 0. Okay, because the leaf node is 0, so no edges are there, that's why 0. What is the height of this 4? So we will calculate the longest path from x to a leaf. This is the height. Okay, height can be calculated like this. So what is the height of this this node 1? So we can calculate the longest path here, 1, 2 and 3. So this entire tree, the entire till here is called as the height. So number of edges 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so this is how you can calculate the height. What is the height of this tree? What is the height of this tree? The longest path from here till leaf node. So this is called as the height. Number of edges 1 and 2. So 2 is the height. What is the height of this node 6? This node 6, we can calculate this as 1h. So the height is 1. Now we have seen the basic terminologies of trees. What is root, what is child, what is sibling. So we have seen all these parts. Now there are various types of trees also available in data structure. So in next lecture we are going to focus on the first part, which is a binary tree. Binary search tree is the most common data structure which is widely used for searching techniques, insertion, deletion. So we will see that part in depth. As far as introduction part is concerned, we have covered all the concepts here. Okay, we'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you for watching.